and welcome to What Are You Saying, where we talk about topics in the news as it affects us all. We have an interesting lineup, which you would find very useful, especially if you are in business. I am Osayuwome Sale, and I am joined by my amazing co-anchors. We have Isi and Nasa.
Hello.
I was going to call her Naza.
No, don't you dare. I think she's gone through Nasa that enough. She Nasa with an S.
She was so traumatized.
She was appalled.
Isi, how are you doing?
I'm very well, thank you. And you?
I'm good.
You're glowing, girl.
Oh, really?
We all are glowing.
Let me. How are you doing, Nasa?
I'm very well, thank you.
How's the home front and how's
work? Home front's fantastic, thank you. Balancing all. I'm a superwoman. You know how I do.
You know how we do.
Is there any news for us, apart from Lagos traffic? Because all of you, you like to complain about traffic all the time.
I think we need to stop complaining about Lagos traffic. It's like part of the way of life.
It's the love of December. Yeah.
There's a spirit,
you know, once is December. Traffic. Yes, once is December traffic, everybody comes out trying to do one or two things before the year runs out. So there would definitely be traffic.
Yeah, but what are people trying to do?
It's the love of Lagos.
Okay, you say so.
Okay. All right, we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. You're still watching Ways on Plus TV Africa. Now, here's what we found as today's quote. We don't have a choice on whether we do social media. The question is how well we do it. That's credited to Eric Qualman. Now, I'm happy that this quote came up today because we're talking social media, we're talking the effects of technology on businesses, you know. So, like, what he's saying now, we don't have a choice. Exactly. It is how we're doing it. So, are you really active on social media, Isi?
I think about a year ago, I was totally out of it. But recently, I started, and to be candid, I wish I had started a long time ago. Mm. Because if you're not on social media, it's like you're not existing at all.
Absolutely.
Yes.
And I agree with Isi, you know. I think being on social, there's a lot of information that you get firsthand on demand. So you know what, social media, as far as I'm concerned, is an enabler, it's critical. And, you know, and according to this person that gave the quotes, it's depending on how you use it, but there's a lot of positives and just, you know,
of course,
harness it to the
best. Of course. I'll talk more about social media probably later in the show. We also found that today is the International Bartender Appreciation Day.
Yes.
Every 6th of December, we celebrate people who spend hours on the other side of the bar, people who make the world taste better. Mm. So here's to every bartender.
Bottoms
you know, because
up.
It's so interesting.
Cheers, absolutely.
You know, it's so interesting because, you know, truly, you know, when I saw this, I found it worthy of mention because we've seen a lot of people that they feel that, oh, they want to drown in their misery, blah, blah, blah. They'll just go and sit down. And the bartender doesn't have any choice.
And
he just has
so
to sit down
and listen to all their stories.
Listen.
And they're nice and they turn it up and they shake the bottles and the
You see, I have to ask you this question.
I can't relate to this. I don't know.
You see, I have to ask you this question. Have you ever gone to go and find Suko inside the bar?
Like she's done.
Because she's
like, she knows
I'm a culprit.
You're a culprit, okay, girl.
So here's to that bartender that made sure Isi came back to us alive.
Absolutely. Yes. Thumbs up, guys.
All right. That was just an aside. Today, we have a lot of stories in the news. And we're going to start with you, Isi, quickly.
Okay.
What exactly did you find in the news for us today?
Okay. In the news, it was reported in Leadership newspaper that we have 12.5 million Nigerian children. And currently, we have about the number wasn't actually stated, but we have about 5 to 14 years of age out of school. or not having quality education. And we also have 61% of children who are between the ages of 6 to 11 years of age who are not in school as well.
That was reported by UNESCO?
That was reported by UNESCO, actually. Wow. Yes. And that is a serious issue. If we keep having this in Nigeria currently, what kind of crop of youth are we going to have in the future? What do you think about that?
Nasa, I think you also had something, a story on education
Absolutely.
That you found.
Yeah. Yes, I do. And, you know, it's interesting that this is coming up because it just tells us how important this is. So, according to The Guardian, the former vice president, Atiku Abubakar, he's accused the state government of misusing funds. So, basically, they've been diverting funds meant for the development
education.
Of the education sector to other uses. And so what this means is the already... the education sector that is already not thriving, and we need to put more money in. So because the allocation from the government isn't enough as it is, and then it's been diverted. It doesn't even make sense. So some of the key challenges for education in Nigeria is poor infrastructure, you know, teachers not getting paid enough. So he said the Senate needs to enact a law to penalize governments that are doing this, and he's concerned for the youth who then don't get into university because the infrastructure doesn't exist to accommodate the applicants.
Ever visited the Ministry of Education? Who has ever visited the Ministry of Education? That's the structure itself speaks for itself.
You know, funny enough, when you mentioned Atiku, because I am married to someone from the north, specifically Adamawa State, where Atiku is from, and recently we had to go to, for the first time, I had to go visit Yola. You know? And when I saw the children in his university, I think the American university, were coming back home. I mean, these are students you would normally see in the top universities, in top universities
in
outside
the
country.
The
so these are people that the parents could easily afford them going outside the country. And by the time I made my findings, I found out that school is really, really top-notch. So Atiku, I think he's done a lot in terms of investing
in education.
So when he's saying something like this,
he's actually passionate about it.
I, on the other hand, Atiku is still in the news, but on another different level. And because it's been going wrong, we cannot say, we cannot turn a blind eye on Showore's issue.
Absolutely.
He was released on Thursday and rearrested today.
Yeah.
You know,
that's
by the DSS.
He
was released yesterday and rearrested today. And Atiku is talking. He was saying that they should show a bit of respect to the judicial and the constituted authority. And he's also saying that, I mean, in his words, that it is a rape on the sanctity of the court. You know, they should, I mean, if the court have said release this man, you shouldn't, you know, come other way and, you know, and rearrest and all of this drama that we're finding.
It doesn't make sense.
And it doesn't tell everyone that we truly have a democracy. It's more like a dictatorship.
Absolutely. Yes,
then
absolutely.
Also the Center for Transparency Advocacy, their executive director, Faith Nwadishi, she described Showore's arrest as rascality and disrespect to the judiciary. So everybody is saying that. Everybody is saying that. The truth is that we understand that there are a lot of, because DSS, on the other hand, on the 3rd of December, they released a report that they have, I mean, let me just quote them. They uncovered syndicated plots for undesired groups to break down law and order in various parts of the country, including Abuja. They want to instigate mass action, mass protests, violence, and all of that, and they want to cause anarchy and destabilize the country. That's what DSS released on the 3rd of December.
Okay.
So today
is the 6th. So why was he released later rearrested?
What I was saying, so it's possible that the new rearrest is linked to the fact that, you know, maybe there's a planned protest that they have. But for me, did you guys watch the video?
They reported it on the 3rd, and, you know, they released him yesterday.
Yesterday, Thursday.
It doesn't add up.
It's not insane.
It's not adding up. But did you watch the story?
Something is not adding up.
It was really, really pathetic what I saw. Marianne Oko, our political analyst on Plus TV Africa, she showed me the video on her phone. It was really pathetic that you would actually, it was a, like real dragging.
Tussle.
Somebody was, a tussle. Somebody was dragging Sowore, and you know, it doesn't make any sense.
He's not a criminal, so why is he being treated like one?
And he's not been convicted, you know, so I don't know why we cannot just be sensible and just
and
do
civil.
Things.
Civil.
Yeah, we just
civil.
Need to be civil. That's the right word. We need to be civil. If the court has said, on this grounds, release this person, you release. Then if you have stronger dissent, then you don't even need
then
force.
You don't need force.
Don't you see how they do it abroad?
You
know, they say, oh, hello,
I watched
sir,
the video of his mom sending a video. I mean, the mom was begging the president that her son visits her every December. Like, look, that's the video showing on screen right now.
Wow.
It was just pathetic. How can you, you know, an operative of the...
And this is a citizen of Nigeria, for Christ's sake.
It doesn't make any sense. You know, so but we are hoping that our leaders are watching and they're saying that this thing, the effect, because that's the power of social media.
Exactly.
In those days, you could do these things and get away with it.
Absolutely.
But now it's gone viral. All the international media, they're taking up this video. And so that's the power of social media. So we need to understand and watch all of these things. So that's where we'll leave it at what's in the news today. So up next, we talk social media and its impact on businesses, and we'll be having our guests. Please stay with us, we'll be right back.
Thank you.